Now we're going to have some fun. We're going out to visit Kathy. And those of you who have been watching this broadcast for a long time have met Kathy before. Kathy is a young lady who is courageously doing a major renovation magnificently well, except it's taking her forever. Kathy, are you there? I asked you to get a drill and a drill bit. Okay, so show me what you got. Sort of standard.
Yep, this is what you suggested. You said a dowel. There's my dowel.
Okay.
There's my drill bit.
Okay, and drill bit.
Yep.
And you got a Black & Decker cordless drill. Okay, so that's cool. Now, one of the nice things about those type of drills, I've got a Makita that's very similar here. And one of the nice things is that the place you hold on to is pretty small, so it's easy to grab a hold of. And you're a lefty, right? Can we see mine here? If we can come over to, there we are. And so you can see it's easy to get a hold of that because it's not very large. The old drills used to be really big handles, but it's now pretty easy. So show me how you hold your drill.
Okay, so we have, okay, all right. So you said shoulder height, right?
Okay, shoulder height. We're going to go in, and the objective, we want a nice straight hole that goes straight in, doesn't go uphill, doesn't go sideways. Yeah, doesn't go like that, doesn't go like that. Now, why do you have it in your right hand? I thought you were a lefty.
No, it's in the left hand. Trust me.
Okay. Okay, it's in the best hand.
Okay. Okay.
So, as you're, okay, that's what we can see from the top. And then from the side, let's go see Mama there.
Yeah.
So, Zach, can you give us that other shot from the side?
That's from the bottom shot here.
Yeah. Okay, going up. But don't we have Mama there with a camera on the side? Oh, there we are. There's the side shot. So we do have a side shot and a bottom shot and a top shot. Okay, so let's just drill a hole.
Okay.
Just drill a straight shot.
Not to peek and cheat, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good?
Okay, go.
Oh, you...
Well, from here, it doesn't look too bad. It wasn't quite horizontal. And does that dowel fit in so you can see how well it looks?
Wait.
If you got the dowel, then you'll be able to see if it looks like it's going to be coming straight out. Does that look good to you?
Well,
I would say it's going a little bit downhill there, huh? And then from that side, we can't quite tell, can we? But one of the things to notice is as you're holding this, your drill was a bit above your arm, right? So it was like this. Here we go, like this. So your drill was a little bit like that. One of the problems with that is our pressure as we push in tends to pivot as you go like this. And so as we're going to go in, pivots like that. And the other one, you were pretty well lined up. What we want is to be right behind it like this. If you get your elbow over here and go in, what happens is it twists like that as we go in. You see?
Yeah.
Now, I can show you better on a smaller drill. The old drills in the old days, all right, I'll go over to my close-up camera if we can take a look at that. In the close-up camera here is they used to have a place for a finger right here. So we did not hold it like this. We held it like this. And what does that finger do? It's a little harder to do with this big guy because there's not really a place built for it. But slide up, pull with your middle finger, and point with your other finger out towards the job. Now let's go back to Kathy, if we can see Kathy again. Kathy, if you change your hand. Okay, that's right. What do you feel in your shoulder? Try to push against the wall.
Okay.
Now, if you get right behind it, because most people get right behind it and try to look at it to make sure it goes straight.
Yeah.
Move your body over right behind the drill like most people do when they don't have a camera on. Okay.
Hold on. I'm just going to give us a better area.
Okay. So if you get like that, drop your finger down. drop your finger down the way you had it before, move over right behind the drill, and you'll feel it's still comfortable.
Yeah.
Now, while you're there, put your finger up, and you'll feel that's not comfortable.
Absolutely.
So it moves you over and brings your shoulder in line with the drill. So with that finger up, don't you have a feeling you want to move your feet?
Absolutely.
Do it. Move your feet over, and your arm just came in line with the action. You see? And that's what's going to keep you from drilling to the right or the left. And the higher you can get on the drill, the less you'll twist uphill or downhill. So try drilling with that finger out there. See what that feels like.
When you say higher up in the drill, you mean
higher up on the drill? What I'm really saying, I didn't bring in I had a good old Rockwell drill that actually had a place for your hand to go this high on the drill. Molded that way. Now they lost it all when they brought out all these battery drills. And unfortunately, the manufacturers have lost the ergonomics of sliding in, like I can do on this little guy. I can put my pressure right here in line with the bit. Mm-hmm. And the finger out there, when I come in like that, it's going to be very straight.
Got it.
Now, we can't quite do it with these, so you have to compensate a bit. But the higher you go, the more you have that tendency.
Got it.
Okay? But I just want to drive home to everybody who's listening that it can be fun, that it doesn't have to be super professional. We can work our way through it, but we can get in close. In fact, Linda, I think you're listening. Can you come down lower and see how close you can get to her drill? Just let's say we need her to really understand that drill. Or get right down there. You see how we can get in and really see the detail. Oh, while you're there, Linda, look at the pegs you put in. See if you can show that peg to us. If we can see if it's nice and straight into the wall. Doesn't look like it's perfectly straight, but that might just distortion me. But I think you did better than I expected you to do. Well, okay, Kathy, that's fantastic. And I see you've got a lot of work on your hardwood floor to do. We'll be talking to you again about how to reverse the direction of hardwood flooring right in the middle of the hallway.
Yeah.
So that's one of her other challenges. Thank you so much, Kathy.
Thanks so much.
And Linda and
thank
Mama.
Hi.
Thanks to all of you. So if we can have fun in renovation and at the same time really get in and get down to the details, it's worth spending 5-10 minutes together and seeing that.